And then we have Terry Johnson, who is the Vice President of Sales and Marketing for the 2010 Alltech FEI World Games. He has been working on this for a long time. Terry has extensive knowledge of marketing, getting things together. You have worked for everywhere from the Big East Conference, the University of Kentucky, of course, in the SEC. Mm-hmm. You've worked in major conferences. You've been to major sporting events. When you come into all this, and I know you've been at it for a few years now, Terry, what is the difference in marketing World Equestrian Games as opposed to marketing, say, a major college basketball or football or professional sports event?
Well, one of the things, Kenny, is those events, whether it be basketball or football here in the United States, you see them on television. Whether you're a fan or not is another story, but you see them on television every weekend, every weeknight sometime, in some cases. And so the education level of what the sport is there. In the case of the Alltech FEI World Equestrian Games, what you have are sports that maybe aren't on TV every single weekend. That's why things like Horse TV and H-SPAN and our relationship with NBC Sports and some of the other relationships that are coming about because of this event are so important and so vital. We currently have in the neighborhood of 25 to 30 sponsors already signed on as partners of the games, and starting with the top one, which is Alltech, our unbelievable title sponsor, who's been an amazing and continues to be an amazing partner, who have never done anything like this before, and much less in horse sport, to Rolex, which is a very tried and true sponsor in horse sport for many, many years. Those are the two top examples of one that has been involved before and one that has not. And we've also been able to bring on folks like Ariat, which I'm sure many of the viewers are accustomed to seeing, their competitive boots and apparel. John Deere, which I'm quite sure that all of your viewers will know of John Deere. Maidan, which is a Dubai-based company, and our newly announced relationship with Beam Global Brands and Maker's Mark. So we've been able to provide an atmosphere and a climate where we've gotten both sponsors who have been involved in horse sport before and those who have not in a large way. John Deere has been involved with horse sport in different levels, but this is the largest thing they've ever come together and done. And that's to the benefit of not only our event, but the benefit of to horse sport in general going forward, because what we're doing is introducing these fans and these spectators to this corporate climate for the first time. So we're very excited. We're very pleased with where we are. We've got some more work to do. We've got many, many relationships and many conversations going. We're comfortable that we're going to be able to provide a platform for those brands and others.
So you're telling me if somebody calls up today and says, you know, Terry, could I become a sponsor?
I will leave this interview in the middle of it to go answer that phone call. No, yes, we are still working on some things and some very exciting things, but
can you compare it to anything else that you've seen out there for the general guy that's loving his football, baseball, hockey, basketball, but still might wonder, why do I want to come watch a bunch of horses, as some might say, for 16 days?
Well, and I would say that the biggest reason is because you've seen all the football, basketball, baseball. there's not a whole lot different when you go to those.
Do you see this also, Terry, in kind of a broad sense, being a breakthrough for equestrian competition by, as you mentioned, getting the exposure as they're getting now on Horse TV, H-SPANs, they'll get it later on with NBC, they're bringing in more sponsors. Do you see this as kind of a needed more opening or more closing the gap between what has been the mainstream and what has been the equestrian set? And most even in the equestrian set would say that's always been different than the horse racing set. So,
right.
So some have seen that there are barriers that have been up you know, either real or imagined?
No question. Absolutely no question. The Rolex Kentucky three-day event that happens here every April has been on NBC and been very successful for a number of years. But the rapidity of and the frequency of having horse sport on television, to have it marketed and promoted the way it is and has been in Europe, is something we haven't had here necessarily outside of some of those examples. So this is a breakthrough moment. I think, as John would attest, there are other states who are wanting to build similar facilities. We just have a 30-year head start on them, and we've done it better. But they're using these games as part of their rationale for why they want to do this, because they see what the Kentucky Horse Park has done. I believe for horse sport, this is without question an iconic moment. We take that responsibility very seriously. But it's also an opportunity for this to grow outside of Europe, because this event is now coming outside of Europe for the first time. And our European friends who have done it so well and started this event, hopefully we'll be able to show them a ways that we can do things and give them appreciation for what horse sport in America is.
What have you learned from the past World Equestrian Games is going to be different with the games that will be here in the U.S. and at the horse park?
Well, for one thing, the mini Epcot experience that we're discussing, we have 1,200 acres that on the Kentucky Horse Park. We're using every square inch of them for the public, but it does offer us an opportunity that maybe other locales, other venues haven't had, which is space. And because we have space, we have the ability to produce some of these other attractions, the Kentucky Experience, the Alltech Experience, the Gift from the Desert Art exhibit that is going to be going on at the Kentucky Horse Park, and the Equine Village and exhibitions, and the list goes on and on. Other venues haven't had that opportunity to do that because they haven't necessarily had the space. So we're trying to take advantage of that in the best way. And what we've learned from the past events is this is a mixture of culture and sport. It's the highest level of competition in sport, but it's also a mixture of culture. It's art, it's music, and other aspects of the life in Kentucky and what Kentucky's all about. So we're taking that very seriously. Again, what we are trying to do is open this event to not just those of certain financial means,
right,
but just horse enthusiasts. We're trying to, every discussion we have about all these different things is how do we make it flexible so people can react the way they need to react, and especially in these economic times.
Mm-hmm. As far as getting credential requests from people who aren't with a horse magazine or something related, have you noticed anything like that yet, or is it still too early?
We have, and Amy Walker and her staff and our public relations department are working diligently on that very subject. We are working to first and foremost make sure we provide a media credentialed area where the working media in equine sport will have everything they need, and then some. We want this to be the best experience they've ever had at the workstations and all those types of things, but also bring in non-equine media representatives to try to broaden, again, what we talked about, the culture and the sport together.
Terry, thanks very much.
Thank
best
you,
wishes, and I'm sure we'll be checking in soon to find out the progress with all the sponsors and what else is
appreciate
going on.
Appreciate this, and appreciate Horse TV and H-Span doing this today.
This is fun, isn't it? At least
it's great.
To get everybody together and ask, if for nothing else, I'm just glad that we got cleared up this whole thing about tickets and our ticket sales down and can I get a place to stay if I come. Those are the two questions, if I've traveled the country, that's been asked the most.
Apples to apples, we've sold tens of thousands of tickets already, and you talk to most major events, they'll tell you the same thing. We're in pretty good shape.
Thank you for watching, and from the Kentucky Horse Park in Lexington, I'm Kenny Rice. Goodbye, everyone.